Hello, good morning. Now, we all know that one of those seminal moments in a company's life is that day when it lists. And today, we're very pleased to have in the studio David Stadnick, who is the chairman of World High Life, which has just listed today in London. David, very good morning. Thank you very much indeed for joining us. So, tell us about World High Life.
Charlie, first off, thank you very much for having me and having our company speak today. It's an exceptionally beautiful day today because we're listing and we're so excited about that as a corporation and as a company. So World High Life started about, we put the wheels in motion probably a year ago. We really got things going about 6 months ago. We were looking around the world, where are we going to go? I'm originally from Canada. And we said, where are we going to go? Where is the next hot spot in the cannabis, medical cannabis, and CBD space? So we said, you know what? It has got to be London and the UK. So we got all the wheels in motion. We're public market guys, and we formed the company. We got all the, like I say, the wheels in motion, and here we are today. We've raised some money. We're actively in business, and we're ready to go.
So tell us, what is the business plan?
Well, we're listed as an investment company. And so what we've been doing is we've been kicking a lot of tires here in the UK. By the way, there are some great, and I mean great, CBD medical marijuana companies here in the UK. You guys got to be awful proud of it, especially the CBD companies. I'm telling you, they're phenomenal. So we've been kicking some tires, looking at them, and we'll see where that goes. But we're also looking at other companies in Europe to see where that goes too.
So the idea is you're going to invest in other companies that are or are not listed.
We have the option to do both, but we are going to invest in companies that are private now, that we'll look to take them. They will ultimately become one of our assets, and we'll take them. They will become a public entity in our entity, World High Life.
And is that then your exit strategy, so to speak, when they become public?
It would be their exit strategy.
Right.
Not necessarily our strategy.
Right.
Ultimately,
so you might continue to keep the holding, retain the holding after they've gone public?
Absolutely. They become public through us.
Yeah.
And then we'll be looking at other acquisitions too. We're not just, as an investment company, we're not looking at just one investment. We'll be looking at several. So the first one will probably be a very big one. And then we'll look to build around that investment.
So just so I understand this, so when you say their exit strategy, does that mean they would reverse into you? You would offer them the vehicle that's listed.
That's right.
And that would be their means of getting a listing then, would be to
each reverse into you. That's correct.
Yeah.
Each deal is different, though. Like some people may want more cash, less stock, but they will definitely be exiting. So, but like I say, each deal is different. They may want more stock, less stock, but they'll ultimately own shares in World High Life, and we'll own them. That's the plan anyway. But sometimes we may find an extraordinary investment opportunity where we might decide we only want to take 10% of it. Maybe it fits our portfolio of what we're doing. We're looking at lots of opportunities, but the big ones are taking, you know, full advantage of buying a whole company. That would be our first priority. That's kind of what we're looking at right now.
So the key here is to buy low and sell high, or buy low and watch the value of your investment appreciate.
I think the companies that we are looking at, the people that we are buying it off, they're going to get fair value. But I think the people that invest in World High Life, I think they're going to have an incredible opportunity. Like I say, I think there's some brilliant companies here. There's some good CBD medical cannabis mines in this country. And the people I'm talking to, I think going public is going to be a great opportunity for not only them, but also for the people that are investing in World High Life.
Are the prospects for cannabis and cannabis-derived products, are they already not priced into financial assets yet?
Well, first off,
of saying that is, are there bargains to be had out there still?
That's an interesting question. I think that there are still some good opportunities out there, especially here in the UK. It's immature, becoming a little bit more mature of a market, especially in the CBD. And it's only medical cannabis that we're even looking to do. But I think that it's not like Canada or the US. Like the UK is now kind of where Canada was 5 or 6 years ago, and the US maybe 3 or 4 years ago. Like you know, I think we're going to be the second or third company going public in the UK, which I love that opportunity. That's what gets me so excited. But there's, you know, there's lots of opportunities here to get by. I think we're going to be one of the first in there that are going to make some acquisitions in the medical cannabis space and the CBD space. There's going to be a lot of people following us. We want to be a leader in the space, and I know we are going to be.
And so why listing in London then? Presumably you could have done the same thing if you'd wanted from Canada.
No, every day in Canada I get in my email a few more companies going public. There's in the US, there's more going public. They all go public through the CSE, Canadian Stock Exchange. There are so many companies public, you can't make out one from the other. There are so many coming in there. And it's saturated, it's a mature market. You come here, and you know what? There's only a few companies public. It's very early, it's exciting. You can tell the energy in the city. You're gonna go public. What? Like, when I started the Supreme Cannabis Company, in 2013, like we were one of the top first 10. Now there's 220 cannabis companies listed through Health Canada. Like the energy was amazing. It was people were sometimes cannabis, whatever. But I'm telling you, in a couple of years or a bit of time, the UK is just going to be the same. There, that's where the opportunity is getting in early. Like right now, I think for investors, I think this is where you want to be. It's exciting times. It's going to explode. I really believe that the UK is the next place to be. I've been in Canada. I've been in the US. I think this is just ready to go. I really think the UK market is ready to go. I think in the CBD side, you're ahead of the curve, but not in the public markets. Listen, I believe in being public. I think it's going to be a great opportunity for the people of the UK and the world, because I think we're going to get investors around the world in what we acquire.
So you alluded to the fact there's a bit of a track record there. You said you started the Supreme Cannabis Company in Canada.
Yes.
So to tell us the road, if you like, that you took that company down, and with particular reference to the stock price.
Yes. Well, we started in 2013. We started the company. The industry, people like this nascent industry, we had a stock that was, it was in your neck of the woods, it was a mining company to start with. We changed it to Supreme Pharmaceuticals. We're just looking at different things. We said, let's get into the cannabis space. Sure enough, a few days later, I got one of the biggest opportunities in Canada presented to me to have the biggest grow facility in the country. And one thing came, we ended up doing it. It happened so quickly, we did a deal on the back of a napkin. Anyway, the people that put in their money in that deal, if you put in 25 grand, became worth like millions and millions of dollars. So, and we've raised the Supreme Cannabis Company, who they also, they're good friends of mine. I started it, I brought in my buddies. They actually have formed Supreme Heights, a subsidiary of their own, but it's private. It's here in the UK too. It's a private company. My buddies, a little bit of my competition now, and they're my buddies. And I started that company, but they're here too. They formed Supreme Heights. They're trying to do the same thing. So we're not off the mark. Anyway, I started that company. It's been a huge success. We've raised hundreds of millions. That's been a huge success. We did the Supreme Cannabis Company with Supreme Pharmaceuticals at the time. I don't know, it's probably a half a billion market cap now. I don't know exactly where it is now, but it's a very big and successful company. On the heels of that, we started another one called Friday Night, which is now called 1933 Industries. That's in the medical cannabis space, CBD space in the US. So we had biggest in Canada at the time, anyway, it's still massively big. We raised hundreds of millions, but then we went into the space in the US. That's become incredibly successful there. So we've done one of each. We started a couple more smaller ones in Canada. We're next. Okay. This is where it's at.
David, you alluded there to a bit of a track record. You said you set up the Supreme Cannabis Company of Canada. Just tell us a little bit about that ride that you went on with that company. I would say with specific reference to the share price, but you know, what is the track record you bring?
Well, I started Supreme Cannabis Company approximately 6 years ago. We started it at pennies when the market was just beginning. It became worth, you know, it's a $500 million company now. We've raised hundreds of millions of dollars. It's been an absolute success. my shareholders and the share people that invested in the company have made, I can't even say how much, but a lot of money. So we parlayed that, and that was extremely successful. We parlayed it into a company called Friday Night, which became 1933. Again, the same thing happened. Stock went to pennies, up to dollars, and market cap grew incredibly well. So the two very big successes, pennies to dollars on both of them. We're recreating it. You know, we've done it several times before. We're doing it again. We're doing it here in the UK. I love the fact that we're in early. There's hundreds and thousands of cannabis companies in Canada and the US, medical cannabis. We're here early. We're just getting going. We have a track record. We've done it. I got all the big guys that have made a lot of money in the medical cannabis and CBD space, they're all personally in investing in this company. They know that we know what we're doing. So they're putting their money in, they're backing it, they're going to continue. They're from the biggest brokerage houses in Canada, and they're backing us. So we think we're in pretty good hands.
Let me ask you to look forward in your crystal ball, and okay. 5 years, where would you like to be in your wildest dreams?
I think the type of companies that I'm talking to, and if we can actually acquire one, they're the type that we could be the largest company in the world. Largest CBD, medical cannabis, we can be the biggest and the best. I think we got the early days. This is an industry. Like, if in the old days, if you want to get into, this could be the next Coca-Cola in the cannabis space, medical cannabis or CBD space. That's the type of companies we're talking to. And I think we've got a track record. We've got all the right people involved with us. We've got great people here. Perfect storm.
Excellent. David, thank you very much. We wish you the very best of luck. Ladies and gentlemen, that was David Stadnick there, the chairman of World High Life, which listed today in the London markets. And, you know, a stock that's high, going higher, I'll let you make your own pun up. We'll be back with more such opportunities very shortly. In the meanwhile, this is me, Charlie Gibson, signing off. And until we speak next, you have a capital day.